at APL, we do a lot of things that are really new, cutting-edge technologies. But there's one place that we like to work on things that are really old. Welcome to the APL Meteorite Lab. I'm Nancy Chabot. I'm in the Planetary Exploration Group. And in this lab, we study some of the oldest materials that you can possibly imagine, meteorites. 4.56 billion years old. This is older than any of the planets. It's the first stuff that actually formed the planets. So by studying these, we can look deeper in time. We can also look at other types of meteorites, which have formed many planets and broken into different pieces, letting us look deep inside planets that we can't otherwise. We do a lot of different work here. Andrew is looking at a meteorite that we think is from the asteroid Vesta.
Here I'm examining the different minerals in the meteorites to determine geologic processes that occurred on the planets where they originated. Prior to examining the meteorites on the microscope, first we have to cut them up and mount them to small glass slides. After cutting it to a paper thinness, we can examine it on a microscope to figure out things relating to mineral relationships that can tell us about volcanic activity and impact histories of the planets that they came from.
So along with studying meteorites and cutting them and prepping them in order to do all of that analysis, we actually look at extraterrestrial samples other than just meteorites, and that's what Chenid's working on.
So what we have here is a soil sample from the moon that was brought back to Earth by the Apollo 14 astronauts. And what we're doing here is separating out these small grains in the soil called agglutinates, which formed when particles from the sun and micrometeoroids bombarded the moon, changing the properties of its surface. And we want to learn how this change in properties works, which will tell us about weathering on the surface of the moon.
So another thing we do here is we actually do experiments to try to understand those samples. I like to call this making fake meteorites. We start with a bunch of chemicals and we mix them together in the compositions that we think are in meteorites. And then I hang them in the furnaces, and this essentially melts my sample. And then I take it out, cut it, prep it, make a little sample, and compare it to the actual meteorite. And if they match, then you know that's what happened on the asteroids. And if they don't match, then that gives you some information about what didn't happen. So we do a lot of different things here in the meteorite labs. We look at samples, we run experiments, and there's a lot more that we can do too. So if you're interested, feel free to come by sometime.